I'm Everett Gunther, and this is Ultra Dynamic Sky. Ultra Dynamic Sky is a flexible and easy-to-use sky and weather system for Unreal Engine, providing dynamic clouds, time of day, moon, stars, weather effects, and more for your project in minutes. Its features include customizable dynamic clouds. You can choose from multiple modes, including 3D volumetric clouds, 2D dynamic clouds, and static clouds. Day and night animation creates a complete dynamic time of day experience with a single click. Lights for the sun, moon, and skylight are built in, instantly adding a complete lighting solution to your scene. Stars and moon rendering for vibrant, detailed night skies. Cloud shadows cast by both the sunlight and moonlight. Aurora effects can be enabled at night, either a simple 2D effect to be used alongside clouds, or a full volumetric aurora, which replaces clouds. Use the space layer to add planets or moons to the background. Create modifiers to change the look of the sky and lighting with game events. Simulation features allow calculating sun, moon, and stars orientations using real-world coordinates with the date and time. And there are hundreds of exposed settings to customize the look and behavior of the entire system to suit your project. But Ultra Dynamic Sky isn't just a sky, it also comes with Ultra Dynamic Weather included. Ultra Dynamic Weather is a fully featured weather blueprint which integrates directly with the sky to easily add weather effects to your project. Its features include effects for rain, lightning, snow, and dust. The weather particles have a collision system to keep them from going through scenery and to allow things like raindrops creating splash particles. Select from settings presets like thunderstorm, light rain, and blizzard, or easily make your own. Add material effects to make surfaces wet or covered in snow as the weather changes. Sound effects are included for all weather conditions, and a built-in sound occlusion system can quiet them inside interiors. A variety of ways to control the current weather. You can manually trigger a weather change by calling the Change Weather function, or you can enable random weather variation that periodically selects a new random weather state. The likelihood of each weather can be customized and can change depending on the current season. Add a weather override volume to your scene to have weather change regionally across large maps. Outline a region using the spline, and the weather state will change when the player is inside. A radial storm can be spawned and move across the level, with effects for the storm to be visible in the distance. The dynamic landscape weather effects add snow and puddles to a landscape, along with simple-to-implement interaction effects for snow trails and puddle ripples. And just like the sky, there are extensive settings to customize all of these features to fit your needs. Ultra Dynamic Sky is designed to make setup as quick and simple as possible. Here I have a scene with no sky or lighting. It's important to make sure you've cleared out any directional lights, fog, skylights, sky atmosphere, volumetric clouds, or sky spheres. To add Ultra Dynamic Sky, just navigate to the Blueprints folder and drag the actor into the scene. And that's it for basic setup. UDS will configure its built-in lights for the time of day, just like that. Before we move on, here's how to access the documentation for UDS. You can either open the README utility in the Blueprints folder, or you can use this shortcut to it at the top of the UDS details. Note, every category of settings on UDS also has a link to the entry in the documentation about it. Also, keep in mind that just about every setting on UDS has a tooltip. So if you need to know what something does, just hover it for an explanation. Alright, let's look at the settings on Ultra Dynamic Sky. Basic controls is where you can adjust things like the time of day and cloud coverage. Sky mode determines what kind of clouds the sky will use, if any. Project mode is set to game/real-time by default, but setting it to cinematic/offline is best for projects rendering movies or stills. The Animate Time of Day category is where you can start a day-night cycle when the level is played. You can adjust day length and night length to determine how fast the cycle goes. The Volumetric Clouds category is where you can adjust everything about the appearance of the volumetric clouds. A key setting here is Volumetric Cloud Rendering Mode. By default, this is set to background-only clouds, which prioritizes fidelity, but the clouds will always be rendered behind objects. If you need them to obscure objects, or if you're going to bring the camera up into the cloud layer, you should change to one of the modes called Clouds Render Over Opaque Objects. The 2D Dynamic Clouds category is similar, but for adjusting the 2D Dynamic Clouds if you have that sky mode selected. The static clouds category has a few settings for changing the texture and rotation of the static clouds. Cloud movement is where you can adjust the speed and direction of the clouds. Note that if you're also using ultra-dynamic weather, cloud direction will be controlled by the wind. The cloud wisps category controls the subtle static layer of high-altitude clouds. You can adjust it or change the texture it uses here. The simulation category is where you can enable sun, moon, and stars, which are oriented using latitude and longitude coordinates, as well as the date, time, and time zone. In the sun category, you can adjust the appearance of the sun disk, as well as settings for the sunlight, like its mobility, intensity, and color. You can also manually position the sun from here if you want, by checking Manually Position Sun Target. With that enabled, just select the Sun Target widget and move it around to reposition the sun. The moon category is much like the sun category, but with options for things like the moon phase or a custom moon texture. In the skylight category, an important setting is the skylight mode. By default, the skylight mode is capture-based, with real-time capture enabled. You can change to modes which dynamically tint a static cube map texture or a simple custom cube map. The directional light category has a few settings which apply the same to the sun and moon directional lights. In the cloud shadows category, you can adjust the intensity and softness of the cloud shadows cast on the scene. In the exposure category, you can adjust or disable the auto exposure settings applied by UDS. The settings apply an exposure compensation curve and allow adjusting exposure bias with time or weather. The fog color and fog density categories have settings to customize the color and density of the height fog and how it changes with time and weather. The volumetric fog category allows enabling volumetric fog, as well as a global volumetric material which can render additional noise and ground fog coverage. The dust category can affect the height fog to fill the area with dust of an adjustable color. This is used by ultra-dynamic weather for its dust effects. The sky atmosphere category exposes settings on the sky atmosphere component, which are controlled by time or weather. These are only used if the color mode on UDS is set to sky atmosphere. Similarly, the simplified color category is used only with simplified color mode. The settings here determine the sky and lighting colors, as well as cloud colors for 2D and static clouds. In the stars category, you can adjust the intensity and color of the stars and apply your own custom star textures. The space layer category is where you can add planets or moons which render in the sky. Each one you add can be individually configured with different textures, parameters, and can be parented to move with the sun or moon. The sky glow category can add light to the sky irrespective of the sun or moon. Night sky glow adds a soft glow of starlight to night skies. Light pollution lights up the night sky from below and limits the visibility of the stars. The aurora category is where you can enable the 2D aurora effect, or you can use the same settings to adjust the look of the volumetric aurora. In screen space light shafts, you can enable and adjust the light shaft bloom effects for the sun and moonlights. The lens flare category is where you can add an optical lens flare to the sun. In post-processing, you can add post-process components which fade their blend weight in and out based on time and weather. You can use this to have things like color grading effects which are specific to when it's raining or when it's nighttime. The water category is where you can enable a simple caustic effect applied to the sun and moonlights beneath a global height level. The modifiers category is where you can select what sky modifiers the system will start with. A sky modifier is a data asset you can author, which can affect a wide selection of float and color properties on the sky. They can be selected here, but also added and removed with smooth transitions at runtime. In cinematic offline rendering, you'll find the quality overrides which are applied at runtime if project mode is set to cinematic offline. The scalability performance category has a few settings related to the blueprint's performance optimizations, and also an option to have the sky mode used by UDS change based on the effects quality currently used. The interior adjustments category can allow some settings for things like fog and lighting to be adjusted when the camera is inside an interior. For example, I can use these adjustments to make volumetric fog rays more exaggerated when inside the interior. To set up ultra-dynamic weather, first make sure your scene has ultra-dynamic sky. You can't use the weather system without the sky. Then just drag the actor into the level. It will hook itself up to UDS and take control of cloud coverage, fog, dust amount, and cloud direction. You can change the weather by selecting one of the presets in Basic Controls. There's partly cloudy, overcast, foggy, light snow, blizzard, thunderstorm, dust storm, and more. But if you want to create your own, you can, by duplicating the existing ones in the Weather Presets folder and changing their settings. If no preset is selected for weather, the system will use the manual weather state, defined here in the category below. From here, you can also apply each weather state value as an override. So for example, you could have the rain preset selected for weather, but take manual control of wind intensity on its own. Next are the categories for adjusting the rain, snow, and dust particles, as well as shared settings used by all three. You can set how many particles will spawn, their size, their color, and more. This is also where you can adjust the collision the particles use by default. The season can either be set using the date on UDS or left unset to be controlled manually. The season variable itself is a float from 0 to 4, starting with spring. In the random weather variation category, you can enable random variation and customize its behavior. The probability of each weather is determined based on the current season using these probability maps. In each map is all of the weather presets that can be chosen and a value of probability for each. You can also select a climate preset, which will set the probability maps to approximate real climate types. The lightning category has settings to adjust both the visible bolts of lightning and the obscured lightning, which softly lights up the clouds. The material effects category is where you can control how the material effects change with weather. By default, material state changes over time using values like wetness coverage duration and snow melt duration. You can disable simulate changing material state over time to make the materials respond instantly instead. The dynamic landscape weather effects category contains the settings for controlling the associated material function of the same name for use on landscapes. In the sound effects category, you can toggle the sound effects and adjust their individual volume levels. Sound occlusion is where you can disable or adjust the system which attenuates the weather sounds inside interiors. You can adjust the amount of that attenuation and the settings asset which defines the specifics of how occlusion is sampled. In the wind direction category, you can enable a simple random variation of the wind direction. In the wind debris category, you can enable an additional particle effect which adds debris particles to the air when the wind is high. You can select a wind directional source actor here, to be controlled using UDW's current wind intensity and direction. Post-process wind fog adds additional moving fog effects in heavy weather. In screen droplets, you can enable an effect which creates small rain droplets and dripping water on the camera when exposed to rain. Heat distortion adds a post-process effect which shimmers the screen in the distance. It can be applied manually or based on the current temperature. The rainbow category has an option to enable a rainbow when lighting conditions are right, based on the threshold of rain or fog. The water level category can use the setting for water level on UDS to kill weather particles below a global height and occlude sound effects. The temperature category controls the output of the function getCurrentTemperature. Temperature is derived from season, time of day, and weather, using the values here in this category. By default, the Weather Above Volumetric Clouds category will nullify things like rain and snow if the player goes above the volumetric cloud layer. You can disable or adjust that behavior here. Lastly, let's go over how to add weather effects to a material. I'm going to go over the basic setup for a couple of the effects functions here, but remember to read the entries in the documentation for the detailed info on all of the included effects. Here I am in a rainy scene with a simple example landscape and a static mesh, and I want both materials to have weather effects. Let's start with the static mesh. I'll open the material it's using and search for weather to find the included weather functions. The one for general solid meshes is called surface weather effects. This function takes the underlying material using a material attributes pin and outputs the attributes with the effects rendered. I'll use a Make Material Attributes node to package the attributes for the input. Now, I'll make a Static Bool node and set it to True. I'll plug that into Apply Wetness and Apply Snow / Dust to enable both effects. I'll also plug True into Dripping to add an effect of water droplets moving down the surface in the rain. Then I'll enable Use Material Attributes in the material settings so we can plug the output straight into the material result. Now I'll compile, and we have the material responding to the current weather. For the landscape, the setup will be similar, but using the dynamic landscape weather effects function. The DLWE function has inputs and outputs for the individual attributes instead of a single material attributes pin. In this case, this material is using a material attributes output, so I'll have to break the pin to get the inputs for the function. The node for that is break material attributes. Now I'll plug in the base color, metallic, specular, roughness, and normal pins. To enable the effects, it's the same as surface weather effects. Just plug a static bool node of true into the inputs for apply wetness slash puddles and apply snow slash dust. To recombine the material attributes for the output, I'll use a set material attributes node. I'll set all of the attributes that the function outputs: base color, metallic, specular, roughness, normal, world position offset, and pixel depth offset, and then plug the combined material attributes into the material result. Now I'll compile, and the landscape will respond to the weather with wetness and scattered puddles. As a last step, we can make it so our character's feet cause ripples in the puddles and trails in snow using the DLWE interaction component. In the character class, I'll select the skeletal mesh and add a DLWE interaction component. On the component, for its parent socket, I'll select the right foot. Then I'll move the component to the center of mass of the foot. Then I'll do the same for the left foot. Now we have the character's feet causing ripples in the puddles. Since we enabled snow effects too, I can change to snowy weather to see the scene respond with snow coverage, which is interactive as well. To make full use of Ultra Dynamic Sky, be sure to check out the documentation. There are many more features than I could cover in this quick video, but they're all explained in detail there. And if you have any specific questions or need help with anything, please send me an email at support@ultradynamicsky.com. Thanks for watching.